All right, B&H viewers, it's time to flex your photographic muscles. This exercise plan comes to us from Todd Vorenkamp, B&H Pro. Let's get started. Exercise one, 24. Find a location, stand in one spot, and make 24 unique photographs while standing in the same place. Don't move your feet and no repeats. Exercise two, 10 of 1. Make 10 unique or abstract photographs of one small subject. The smaller the subject, the greater the challenge here. So make sure to focus in on something that's tangible and small. Subject like a New York City or Chicago, that's not gonna work here. You may need to employ close-up or macro photography to get the most out of the exercise. Exercise three, 4 corners. Choose one subject and place where it exists in each corner of your frame for 4 images. You can move to the other side of the subject and do the same. Shoot all 4 sides, putting your subject in all 4 corners. See what you come up with. Exercise four, setting artificial restrictions. Now you can create a restriction for yourself for a day, for a weekend, but give yourself some solid limitations, like using a single lens, shooting only in one location, going color only, black and white only, shooting at magic hour, overexposing or underexposing your images, using different metering modes, photograph while sitting, while lying on the ground, making pictures of things that are above you, things that are below you, filling the frame with your subject, using negative space to tell the story. The limits are up to you. Exercise five, shoot a roll of film. Remember, film, you had limits. On 35 millimeter, you could shoot 24 or 36 exposures. Take yourself to a place and limit your maximum shooting number to 24 or 36. Shooting this way really forces you to consider your environment and the limitations of how much you can shoot. If you're having too easy a time with 24 or 36, dial it back to 12, just like in the medium format days. Exercise six, 12 abstracts. You want to photograph a dozen abstract photographs of a single common object. Now, depending upon the size of that object, you might need a macro lens or a telephoto optic. Remember, you don't have to keep all of this in focus. You can move close, you can move farther away. Abstract is abstract, so play around here. Exercise seven, the portable subject. You want to carry something with you. You remember the movie Amelie? Amelie's like taking the gnome around and sending postcards home to her dad. Well, sort of like that. You want to find something that you can carry with you, maybe put it in your camera bag or your pocket, and try to work this subject into your photograph. You can put it in the foreground, you can put it in the background, it can be the main thing, it can be part of the supporting cast of whatever you're shooting. Just make sure to include it. Kind of becomes a Where's Waldo type of thing. Exercise eight, the unselfie selfie, or the self-portrait. All right, so first off, this is not a selfie exercise. You want to bring a tripod or an alternative camera support along with you. Put yourself into the frame, compose, reframe, start your self-timer, and insert yourself into the photograph in a thoughtful and meaningful way. Exercise nine, the mixing bowl. Now, this is sort of like a lot of exercises in one. You want to get a bunch of little strips of paper and then write a restriction or a piece of inspiration, something you want to focus on each one. Reach into a bowl or a hat, pull out what you want to work on. That could be like shooting with soft focus, longer exposures, short exposures, shooting as soon as you wake up, making photographs with a weird lens that you own but never seem to be able to use. You get the idea. Exercise 10, the change up. Now try a different genre of photography. If you're a studio person, get yourself out into the street. If you're a documentary and street photographer, maybe you need to find your way into the studio. You shoot architecture, try some sports. Move around. The more you train up your brain, the better the photographer you're gonna be. Exercise 11, the 9 elements. You're going to make 9 unique photographs, each emphasizing the 9 elements of art, including light, shadow, line, shape, form, texture, color, size, depth. For a bonus round, maybe add focus, tonality, quality of light, patterns, negative space. You can make this as simple or challenging as you like. Just be sure to allow yourself only 1 image per element. Exercise 12, steps. Go for a walk somewhere that you've always wanted to photograph. And as you're moving through the space, stop and make a unique image after a predetermined number of steps. Now, how many? That's up to you. 10, 15, 20? What's your favorite number? Want to make a picture every city block? It's interesting the way the world changes as we shuffle our feet. Exercise 13, 2 trips. Go to a space, maybe you've been there before, maybe you're new to it, without your camera. Water, roads, movement, come back with your camera and make a photographic document of your observations. Well, those are some of the exercises that we have. What do you do to unlock your photographic creativity? Let us know in the comments below. And if you haven't already, like and subscribe. I'm photographer David Flores. See you next time.